dB is equal to mu naught over 4 pi IDL sine theta by R square. So this is the formula, and Biot-Savart law, Biot and Savart were two scientists that together gave magnetic field due to a current element IDL. IDL is our current element, and we can find magnetic field with the help of that. Plus 2A you have done. So we are going to do the application. So side by side you will do on your copy. Okay, that will be a good revision for you as well. So first of all, let us express Biot-Savart formula in the vector form, right? So this is our current carrying conductor. This is the element DL. This is R. Theta is angle between DL and R. T is the point of observation where this magnetic field, small magnetic field, is existing. So dB is equal to mu naught upon 4 pi IDL sine theta by R square. Let us express in vector form. If we find DL cross R unit vector, अगर हम DL cross R find करें क्या होगा? आपको formula आता है A cross B. A cross B is, you know, AB sine theta into the unit vector perpendicular to vectors A and B. Right? Okay. So we can write DL unit vector का magnitude. ठीक है? DL is the magnitude of element DL. Unit vector का magnitude into sine theta over इसका magnitude का square. ठीक है? Right now we are writing only DL cross R. ये हो गया? So what it will become? Unit vector's magnitude is 1. So this is DL sine theta. So see, how can we write DL sine theta? We can write it DL cross R. So substitute it there. Let us write now in vector form. So put a vector now. Mu naught over 4 pi I DL cross R over R square. Now put the formula of unit vector. Unit vector is vector divided by its magnitude. So put R cap is equal to R vector over magnitude of R. We will get mu naught over 4 pi I dl cross vector R over R cube. Because R square was already there, one more R we will get here. So this is how we can write this magnetic field in the vector form. This is Biot-Savart formula in the vector form. Please keep this thing in mind. Now a special case. So we can also comment from here that direction of dB is perpendicular to plane containing DL and R vectors. Because you see here cross product is involved. So we get a third vector which is perpendicular to the vectors A and B. You know, by definition of cross product of two vectors, we will get another vector, C vector, whose direction is perpendicular to both the vectors A and B. So here our two vectors are DL and R. And DB will be perpendicular to plane containing DL and R vector. So you can say if this is A vector, this is B vector, then DB is your C vector. So mind it, what will be the direction of DB perpendicular to plane containing DL and R vectors. All right. One special case. One special case. Here I have shown the observation point at a distance R from the current element. If suppose the point lies on the conductor itself. Agar ye point wire ke upar, conductor ke upar lie karta ho, to kya zero put karenge hum? Theta bhi zero put kar sakte hain. So special case, if P lies on conductor itself, put theta equal to zero here, so dB will be zero, no contribution. So those points, we did the numericals on Saturday, plus 2A, we did the numericals based on this on Saturday, and we saw that those points don't contribute, that lie on the conductor itself. like we did that numerical. This one. So we said that these two portions, this and this, won't contribute because on extending they lie on the conductor itself. Point low O lies on them only. So that's why we nullified their contribution. हमने कहा कि ये दोनों portions contribute ही नहीं करते. ठीक है. Now let us come to the first application of Biot-Savart law. To find magnetic field at the center of circular coil carrying current, we also call circular coil carrying current a current loop. So we are taking a current loop now. First application. First is to find magnetic field intensity at the center of circular coil carrying current. At the center of circular coil carrying current. Or you can say at the center of current loop, circular coil carrying current, or at the center of current loop, you can say, right? So we are taking a circular wire carrying current. Suppose it is carrying current in this direction, and we want to find magnetic field at the center of this loop having radius r. Having radius r. So let us take length element dl. So idl becomes current element, and you can see for a circle, angle between dl and r is 90 degree. Angle between dl and r vectors in case of circle, that is 90 degree. So let us write our formula dB. Let us use Biot-Savart law. Mu naught over 4 pi idl sine theta by r square. But since we see that theta is 90 degree here, sine 90 is 1. So we get dB is mu naught over 4 pi idl by r square. We get dB is equal to mu naught over 4 pi idl by r square. Is that clear? Is that clear, students? Fine. Now integrate both sides to get the total magnetic field intensity. Okay. So this will be mu naught over 4 pi I over r square integral dl. Now what is the whole length? Total length of the circular wire whose radius is r. That is 2 pi r. That is circumference. So we will write integral dB is B, mu naught over 4 pi idl by r square, and integral dl is 2 pi r. Please ask if any step is not clear to you, students. If any step is not clear, you can ask. So we cancel 2 pi to 1 r cancel. Oh, sorry, dl humne put kar diya. Theek hai? So we get B is equal to mu naught I over 2R. This is magnetic field at the center of circular coil carrying current. So this is very small proof. This is small proof for first application. So I hope all the points are clear to you, especially the angle wide, that is 90 degree in case of a circle, because you can see DL is along tangent. And radius and tangent are always perpendicular to each other. So here our theta is 90 degree. Yes, have a look at the whole derivation. If you have any doubts, you can ask. Magnetic field, the pattern we will draw after we will state the rule, Maxwell's right hand thumb rule. All right. And if the circular coil has n number of turns, we'll multiply with number of turns. n into mu naught I over 2r, where n is number of terms. More is the number of turns, more will be the strength of magnetic field. So if we take a coil, you wind more turns, copper wire, turns of copper wire, it will behave like a strong magnet. Right? Now let us come to the second application. To find magnetic field intensity at a point on the axis of circular coil carrying current. Now we want to find magnetic field at a point on the axis of the circular coil. So second application, at the axis, at the point on the axis of circular coil carrying current. And this is very, very important application, usually asked in board exams. So many times this second derivation, second application has been asked in board exam. So please look at it carefully, and we will also comment upon the result later on. We will also derive something from the result, right? So we are having a circular coil which is kept perpendicular to the plane of coil. So I am showing it like this. Ye board ke perpendicular hai. Theek hai? Ye board ke perpendicular hai. Last case mein kya kiya tha humne? हमने कॉइल को ऐसे रखा, ठीक है, हमने कॉइल को ऐसे लिया था, प्लेन में लिया था बोर्ड के. नाउ आई एम कीपिंग द कॉइल लाइक दिस परपेंडिकुलर, आई एम कीपिंग द कॉइल परपेंडिकुलर टू द प्लेन, तो आपको वो ऐसा दिख रहा है, ठीक है. इज दैट ओके स्टूडेंट्स? सो दिस इज द एक्सिस, दिस इज द एक्सिस, एंड वी आर टेकिंग अ पॉइंट पी लाइंग ऑन द एक्सिस ऑफ द सर्कुलर कॉइल कैरिंग करंट. Let us say that the radius of the circular coil is A. ध्यान रखिए, last case में हमने radius R लिया था. Here we are taking radius to be A. Let the current be flowing in any direction. So this is a current loop now. This is a current loop now. Join this and this to the ends of the coil. So let us say this is R and DL. We are taking length elements diametrically opposite. We are taking length elements on both sides diametrically opposite. Let us call them DL and DL dash. Let us call them DL and DL dash. These are two length elements diametrically opposite. Okay? Right? Then let us call it X. So from this right angle triangle, you can write X. R is equal to under the root x square plus a square. So, इसको note करके रख लेते हैं. Now, let us talk about magnetic field created due to this length element here at point P. It is perpendicular to plane containing DL and R vectors. R एक उस plane का एक end तो हमारे पास है. तो इसके perpendicular हम draw कर देते हैं. That will be direction of dB. So this is magnetic field produced by DL length element at point B. So R एक plane का edge है हमारे पास, उसके perpendicular आपने बना. अब due to DL dash, suppose the magnetic field at P point is DB dash. So ये भी R है by symmetry, तो इसके perpendicular आप बनाएंगे DB dash. This will be your DB dash. Is that clear? Let us take these two angles to be phi and phi, right? So, पहले हम लिखते हैं DB कितना है और DB dash कितना. Always for a circle, this theta will be 90 degree. आप कहोगे DL और R में theta 90 degree तो नहीं लग रहा है. But suppose the point is far away. तो जब ये point far away होगा, तो ये line आपकी almost ऐसे होती जाएगी. ठीक है, तो उस time पे आप कह सकते हो कि again the angle between DL and R is 90 degree. So you can say DB and DB dash both, their magnitudes are mu naught over 4 pi IDL over R square. This is our equation number 1. So that means we have found that DB and DB dash both have equal magnitude and directions we have shown. Yahan tak clear ho gaya aapko humne inka magnitude kaise likha? ठीक है, तो अगर आपका डीएल यहाँ पे है तो जब पॉइंट बहुत दूर है तो ये लाइन ऑलमोस्ट हॉरिजॉन्टल हो जाएगी, तो तब ये जो डीएल और आर है ये आपके परपेंडिकुलर हो जाएगी. सो दैट्स वाई फॉर अ सर्कल रिमेंबर इन बोथ द एप्लीकेशंस वी हैव टेकन थीटा 90 डिग्री. ठीक है, वो थीटा था, अब ये फाई है. फाई इज द एंगल दैट दिस आर इज मेकिंग विद हॉरिजॉन्टल. ठीक है, सो नाउ नेक्स्ट स्टेप इज टू रिजॉल्व डीबी एंड डीबी डैश इनटू टू कंपोनेंट्स ईच. सो रिजॉल्विंग डीबी फर्स्ट अलोंग टू कंपोनेंट्स. अब ये देखिए कि इफ दिस इज फाई, इट कैन बी वेरी इजीली प्रूव दैट दिस इज आल्सो फाई, बिकॉज इफ एंगल बिटवीन टू लाइंस इज फाई, एंगल बिटवीन देयर परपेंडिकुलर्स विल आल्सो बी द सेम. सेम वे, चलो पहले इसको रिजॉल्व करते हैं. सो दिस विल बी डीबी कॉस फाई and this is db sin phi, db cos phi and db sin phi. Okay, same way let us resolve this also. db dash ko bhi resolve karte hain. Again this will be also phi. So this component is db dash cos phi and this is db dash sin phi. Now db and db dash being equal in magnitude and db cos phi and db dash cos phi being opposite in direction, these two components cancel out. So we have net magnetic field db sin phi plus db dash sin phi in the acting in the same direction. Okay, so how can we write? Total magnetic field is integral db sin phi. Now why we have written this? Why we have not written 2 dB sin phi? Can anyone tell? कि मैंने इसको 2 dB sin phi क्यों नहीं लिखा? मैंने इसको integral dB sin phi क्यों लिखा? Yes. Who can explain this? Plus 2A you have already done. Please tell me the reason. Why I have not written 2 dB sin phi here? Yes. Yes, anyone? सिया आप बताओगे? सिया, सिया, पवन, यस पवन, विल यू टेल द रीजन? बोलो बच्चे. प्रीतिका आप बताइए. प्रीतिका, प्रीतिका कैन यू स्पीक? अनम्यूट योर सेल्फ.
यस मैम.
हाँ बताओ, मैंने इंटेग्रल डीबी साइन फाई क्यों लिखा है जबकि यहाँ पे दो कंपोनेंट्स दिख रहे हैं जो इक्वल हैं? सो व्हाई आई हैव नॉट रिटन 2 डीबी साइन फाई? कैन यू टेल? ओके, द रीजन इज राइट नाउ वी हैव टेकन ओनली 2 length elements, but such types of pairs of length elements are acting over the entire circular loop. ये दो diametrically opposite हैं, ये दो diametrically opposite हैं, ये दो diametrically opposite हैं. They all will give rise to magnetic field acting in the same direction. All those components will be acting in the same direction. Like we have checked for a pair, one pair. Same way it will be true for all the pairs. This is the reason, that's why I have written integral db sin phi, not 2 db sin. Okay, so what is, now let us put the value of db here. B is mu naught over 4 pi I dl ko andar rakhiye, and sin phi also let us put. Can you write sin phi from this right angle triangle that is perpendicular, which is radius a, over hypotenuse which is r? So sin phi is a over r. We have substituted this. So let us see now, what do you get? B is equal to mu naught over 4 pi I a over r cube. And what is integral dl? What is the length? What is the circumference of the circular loop of radius a? That is 2 pi a. So we get 2 pi a here. Mu naught upon 4 pi 2 pi a square into I. And let us put the value of x also. If x r ki value put kar dete hain, so it becomes 3 by 2. So this is the formula. This is the formula of magnetic field at a point on axis of current carrying circular coil. Keep this formula in your mind. Further, I told you we will discuss the result also. Okay, we arrive at a very important conclusion from this result. First, you have to keep this for numerical purposes. This is the end result, note it down. Ab isko further hum kuch discussion karne ja rahe hain. What is pi a square? This is area of circular coil. So let me put it a. Mu naught over 4 pi 2 I a ho gaya. Theek hai? Over x square plus a square raised to power 3 by 2. Now note down, for example, you have a bar magnet. It behaves like a magnetic dipole. Like you did electric dipole, that is having two equal and opposite charges separated by some distance. Same way, magnetic dipole like a bar magnet is there. It is having two equal and opposite poles of strength separated by a certain distance. So it will be called a magnetic dipole. Right. The formula of dipole moment. In analogy with the electric dipole moment, we have a term magnetic dipole moment also. Magnetic dipole moment, later on we will define it properly. Magnetic dipole moment is denoted by symbol capital M and it is given by the formula I into A. Actually it is NIA. There are some number of terms also, then it is NIA, but the basic formula is I into A. So we will substitute for IA here, we'll put it equal to M, which is the dipole moment. So since the expression contains a non-zero dipole moment, this shows that current loop behaves like a magnetic dipole. So since this expression involves non-zero magnetic dipole moment, that means we arrive at this result that this current loop behaves like a magnetic dipole. So if it is a magnetic dipole, where are its two poles? So pehle ab yahan tak dekh lijiye. Ye paper mein aaya hua hai, board ke paper mein, ki show that a current carrying circular coil behaves like a magnetic dipole mathematically. So this is the proof. Right? And as a special case, we can derive the first application also from here. Because if the point doesn't lie on the axis, if the point lies at the center of the circular coil, put x equal to 0 in this formula. Let us put it here as a special case. Special case, likh liye, likh lo. If point, observation point lies at the center, if observation point lies at the center, x would be 0. So putting in this formula, this is the main formula, mu naught over 4 pi 2 pi a square into I, x ko 0 put kar do, ye aa jayega aapka a cube. Ab do a's aapke kat gaye, to ye bhi aapne cancel out kar diya, so you get mu naught I over 2 a. Wahan pe hamara a nahi tha, r tha. So same expression we are getting, same expression as we had found in first application, so we are getting here also. Okay, so as a special case also you can derive the first application, but first application is already very simple, so we need not derive this complicated formula and then deduce the simpler formula from that, so we can follow the straight method for this. Is that okay, students? Any doubts now? Clear? Okay. So have a look at the whole article once. If you have any doubts, you can ask. ये एंगल आप किसी के साथ भी ले सकते हो, फाई आप इधर भी ले सकते थे, हमने इधर ले लिया, कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है। ठीक है, नाउ लेट अस शो हाउ करंट लूप बिहेव्स लाइक अ मैग्नेटिक डाइपोल, देखते हैं। सो आई एम गोइंग टू ड्रॉ टू फेसेस ऑफ सर्कुलर लूप नाउ। आई एम गोइंग टू ड्रॉ, एक ही करंट लूप है उसके दो फेसेस मैं ड्रॉ कर रही हूं। दिस इज से अपर फेस एंड दिस इज से लोअर फेस। एक ही लूप के दो फेसेस मैंने ड्रॉ कर लिए, ठीक है। लेट द करंट बी फ्लोइंग इन द एंटी क्लॉकवाइज डायरेक्शन। करंट एंटी क्लॉकवाइज डायरेक्शन में फ्लो कर रहा है, ठीक है। तो देखिए ये है करंट, मैं कह रही हूं कि एंटी क्लॉकवाइज डायरेक्शन में फ्लो कर रहा है। आपको क्या लग रहा है, आपको एंटी क्लॉकवाइज लग रहा है या क्लॉकवाइज? यस स्टूडेंट्स, एनीवन? मैं कह रही हूं करंट एंटी क्लॉकवाइज है, आपको क्या लग रहा है, एंटी क्लॉकवाइज की क्लॉकवाइज? क्लॉकवाइज। आपको रिवर्स दिख रहा होगा, तो इसका मतलब इफ करंट इज फ्लोइंग इन द एंटी क्लॉकवाइज डायरेक्शन इन थ्रू वन फेस थ्रू द लोअर फेस इज इट मस्ट बी फ्लोइंग इन द ऑपोजिट डायरेक्शन। तो यहाँ पे हम कहेंगे कि ये क्लॉकवाइज डायरेक्शन में फ्लो कर रहा है। एंड ऑलवेज नोट दैट व्हेन द करंट फ्लोज इन एंटी क्लॉकवाइज डायरेक्शन दैट मींस नॉर्थ पोलैरिटी। And when the current flows in clockwise direction, clockwise means south polarity. So we have proved that this current loop, when it carries current, its upper and lower faces have equal and opposite poles. एक इसका face north pole behave करता है और दूसरा face south pole behave करता है. So we have proved that. And the direction of magnetic dipole moment is always from south to north. So in this case, tell me what will be the direction of dipole moment, upwards or downwards? Bataiye. Upwards hogi ki downwards hogi? Yes, students. What will be the direction of magnetic dipole moment in this case? I told you direction of dipole moment is from south to north pole always, and you can see where are the poles of this current loop. अपर जो है वो नॉर्थ है, नीचे कौन सा है, साउथ है। तो साउथ टू नॉर्थ किधर हुई डायरेक्शन मैग्नेटिक फील्ड की? सो मैग्नेटिक फील्ड डाइपोल मोमेंट दैट इज एक्टिंग इन द अपवर्ड डायरेक्शन। सो इन दिस केस द डाइपोल मोमेंट इज एक्टिंग इन द अपवर्ड डायरेक्शन व्हेन वी से दैट करंट इज फ्लोइंग इन द एंटी क्लॉकवाइज डायरेक्शन थ्रू द अपर फेस। Then that would mean, तो आपने देखे हैं रिंग मैग्नेट्स वगैरह, आपको उनके पोल्स नहीं मिलते, वो सर्कुलर होते हैं। तो उनके पोल्स कहाँ पे होते हैं? वन फेस, अपर फेस बिहेव लाइक वन पोल एंड लोअर फेस बिहेव लाइक अनदर पोल, ठीक है। तो इस तरह से उनके दो पोल्स होते हैं, सर्कुलर मैग्नेट्स के भी होते हैं, बट देयर अपर एंड लोअर फेसेस बिहेव लाइक दैट। So you can justify with the help of these diagrams that yes, current loop behaves like a magnetic dipole. Is that clear, students? Now Maxwell's right hand thumb rule you people have already done. Who will tell me the statement? Maxwell's right hand thumb rule 10th mein bahut acche se kiya hua hai aapne. Who will tell me the statement of Maxwell's right hand thumb rule? Yes students, bataiye Maxwell's right hand thumb rule. Very simple. Kaun batayega? अरे कुछ बोलो। यस, मैक्सवेल्स राइट हैंड थंब रूल। लेट मी टेक द स्क्रीन शॉट ऑफ अटेंडेंस। यस, Maxwell's right hand thumb rule states that if you imagine a conductor in your right hand in such a way that the thumb points in the direction of current, then the sense of curling of the fingers gives the direction of magnetic field lines. Ab yaad aa gaya, theek hai? So it gives us magnetic field direction due to current carrying conductor. So, जब भी करंट फ्लो करता है, Oersted has proved that it will have magnetic field around it, and the direction of that magnetic field is given by Maxwell's right hand thumb rule. Is that clear? All right. So, next article हमारा वही होगा.